tissue expander reconstruction will be done after the mastectomy. The mastectomy basically removes the, involves the removal of the tissue by the breast surgeon, and whether or not the nipple is removed or not, you're left with a skin envelope. And then the expander is placed generally over the muscle with a sheet of alloderm, which is the cadaver dermis that holds it in place. In rare cases, we'll go under the muscle, but we generally don't do that anymore. Postoperatively, it significantly decreases the risk of discomfort. Much more comfortable going over the muscle. It also ends up in the end looking much nicer. So the risks of the procedure, beyond the general risks of bleeding, infection, and wound complications, the biggest risk is seroma, which is a fluid collection. What has to happen is the skin and the alloderm have to adhere over time. That's why there are drains are in. Any fluid that's created, the drains will drain it out. But even with that, there is a risk that you can develop some fluid between there. Try and avoid any shearing, any twisting, which can create shearing forces. If there is a fluid collection, sometimes in the office, we'd have to put another drain back in, or we have to aspirate it with a needle. It is not uncommon, it's almost always the case, that during nipple sparing mastectomies, you'll get discoloration of the nipple just from the change in blood supply. Sometimes you can get something called epidermolysis, where the nipple, actually the skin starts to slough off. These things generally just heal on their own. You can get loss of tissue or loss of or wound complications from the mastectomy itself. That is a much higher risk in smokers, diabetics, and patients who previously had radiation. There is a risk of expander failure. Failure is defined as anything that requires the expander to be removed. That could be from exposure of the expander. You can get an infection. And sometimes it becomes very painful to some patients. This is rare, especially when we go over the muscle, but those are the reasons why the expander would need to be removed. And these, once again, these issues are much higher in smokers, diabetics, and in patients who've had previous radiation.